Welcome to The Hair Loss Show. Dr. Russell Knudsen and Dr. Vikram Jayaprakash discuss issues relating to hair loss and the medical and surgical treatment of hair loss in both men and women.
Hi everyone, and welcome to The Hair Loss Show. I'm Dr. Vikram Jayaprakash. And what I wanted to do today is to follow on from the last episode, which was on medicated shampoos. And what I said we'd do is specifically talk about a specific type on this video, and that is ketoconazole shampoos, otherwise known as, you can find them freely available in any pharmacy. It can be a ketoconazole shampoo or Nizoral or something along those lines. And the active ingredient in that is a topical antifungal called ketoconazole. And I see it get prescribed or recommended a lot. I have to be honest, I don't see a lot of benefit or recommend it, quite commonly. And that's not to say it doesn't work. It may well be that just in what I do and the fact that I deal with hair loss and people have tried these therapies and they're not successful, that group is then coming to see me. So maybe I see I've got a skewed opinion on this particular product. But in essence, it is there, and it's potentially something to try. So let's unpack it a little bit. It is a medicated shampoo, which means that, and if you have a look at our previous video on this, you've got to leave it in for at least 5 to 6 minutes for that to absorb and take effect. So how does it work? Well, there's a couple of different postulated theories on how a ketoconazole shampoo actually helps with hair loss. The first is that it actually acts as an anti-inflammatory, the anti-inflammatory effects of the ketoconazole shampoo. So if you've got someone with a very flaky scalp, seborrheic dermatitis, it may be useful in helping clean that up. Now, that in itself is not a cause of male pattern hair loss, and it's more likely to be the cause of shedding on someone's of hair on someone's scalp. So from an anti-inflammatory perspective, it does not impact the process that is involved with male pattern hair loss. The other way that it's postulated to work is that it has an anti-androgen effect. So it blocks the DHT production. So it's a very weak blocker of that. So I don't think you could put it up against finasteride, for example, and say, oh, look, it's comparable in its efficacy, topical or oral. But it has been shown to have that sort of anti-androgen effect. If you look at the data, they've studied ketoconazole shampoo, and there's been a research paper where it's compared ketoconazole shampoo with 2% minoxidil. Now remember, topical minoxidil that you find freely available over the counter is 5%, but they've compared it with 2% minoxidil, and they've shown in those two individual groups, the efficacy of the ketoconazole is comparable with the efficacy of 2% minoxidil. So, you know, take from that what you will. So I think on balance, it's not something I reach for regularly. I think I would use it if I examine someone, I see that they've got quite a flaky scalp, that may be something that I might consider. But if I'm seeing someone with male pattern hair loss, it's not something I would go, oh, look, definitely be on ketoconazole shampoo. It's not even something I'd probably even consider if someone couldn't tolerate finasteride. So if you trial someone on finasteride and they're unable to tolerate even a small dose, to say, oh, look, try a topical ketoconazole will be sufficient. I think the evidence is not there for that either. So I generally have not seen a great deal of positive results from it, but I would suggest it if I examined someone and saw that someone had quite a flaky scalp. What are the downsides of using it? Well, probably not a lot. It's very safe. Again, you have to make sure that you use it correctly, which means applying it to the scalp, letting it sit on the scalp for 5 to 6 minutes, and then washing it off. There's probably a larger picture to take into consideration, and that is, well, if we recommend it to everyone and everyone starts using ketoconazole shampoo, then there's a lot of ketoconazole that is going to go into the wastewater system, which, you know, as a one-off is not an issue, but over time may potentially build up fungal resistant microbes that can come into existence. So something to think about, you know, from a holistic perspective. But I think, you know, I would recommend it on a case-by-case basis, depending on what I see on the scalp. But I haven't really seen significant benefits of using a ketoconazole shampoo in treating male pattern hair loss. So I hope you find that useful. Hopefully that unpacks that ketoconazole side of things for you. Thanks again for watching. Hope you're enjoying the content. Please don't forget to leave a comment or a question. We'll try and get to as many of them as we can. And hope you're all well and stay safe. Thanks.